Give the mic to the pastor. Pastor Celeste. Long time. I was looking when I was ordained. I was in the back room. And I said, Lord, you told me my latter days will be greater than my first. He told me that through prophecy more than once. All I know is I know people need help. The church need help. And I'm very happy today. I said, Lord, I'm happy. Today when I heard, things are changing. And I think people that's got any sense, changing. Because we see where we are today. We see what's going on. We look at the world. We look at news. I do. Keep up with things. And I really try to keep up with Israel. I believe in what God is doing over there, and I believe it's the time clock. And that's what I was taught, you know. I'm so happy to be here today. I feel blessed, and I feel like going on. I feel like going on. And I just thank the Lord. And I love to hear her in Sunday school, so I try to get... We come in here the last part, and I see sister, she's so inquisitive and love God, and you know, and she be asking questions. That's right, baby, ask them, huh? And I just really thank the Lord for all of you. I thank the Lord for sending you all here that came, Sister Vicky and brother. You know, God just good. I know he wants to do something, so I find myself humbling myself and just say, Lord, do what you want to do. Please, God. The part you told me, not telling what I said, you told me you was going to do, you know, that I started off, okay, come on here now, you know, hey, this is the end of the road here. I got to come. I want to go out with a blaze like Samson. That's what I tell him that, you know, so, and you do too. Praise the Lord. And then I was thinking, I noticed the first Sunday when I saw the, you know, it means something to me. It means, I said, God, show us how to take the sacrament that it may mean something to us, something healing, something different, something that we really know what this is for. So I'm going to go back where he gave it to him and study. Praise the Lord. So I just give God all the praise and the glory this morning. And y'all know, y'all have to discuss because this hair is now. Y'all got to have some respect here and say, Pastor. I want to thank the Lord for my sister back there too, my daughter, Tawana. She loves me. So much that she let me know when things get a little, you know. Thank you, Tawana. I'll never forget you. I'll never, in my prayers, I pray for everybody. But Tawana has a way of telling you things. She just Tawana, honey. And I said, Lord, thank you for Tawana. You know what I'm saying? Because when you love people, you love them. You love them, you see anything, you know, if their slip is hanging or the this or that, you know, you tell them. You know what I'm saying? You love people. Love is love, honey. Love is something. It's something. I was thinking about this precious woman in our neighborhood. My husband would take her greens in the summertime. Daddy had all that was Daddy's garden out there. And he would plant for the saints right in his church. And he would I didn't know he had took greens down to this lady. Her name's Elaine, she said, so she cooked some greens, some mustard and turnips and turnips and mustard for me. And she sent them down, you know, to thank, you know, she don't know Dad, she know Dad's sick, but she know he's not going to church, because, you know, they see him coming and going, and you know. But anyway, so after she brought them down and everything, and she brought it in a little plastic container about like this, like that. So after I said, Lord, he said, fill it with something. So whatever came out of my mouth, I saw three apples and grapes. So I put three apples, I'm going somewhere with this. I put three apples and some grapes and filled it the plastic container that she put the greens in to thank her for sending the greens. And so I went down there, and her name is Elaine. I knocked on the door. Hello, Celeste. I said, I'm fine. How you doing? I said, well, here's your container. I was giving her container back, filled with, because she had filled it up. Well, she called me back. I thought about it. That woman called me back crying. The Holy Spirit told me to put 3 apples and grapes in this container. Now, I didn't hold that much because it's just, the plastic container. And I put it in, and she said, oh, Celeste, who told you that I love apples and grapes? I had a whole day that day. I said, well, God got a way of blessing you, but it's through blessing other people. And that I consider this my Jerusalem. This is my Jerusalem. Where I live, it's my Jerusalem. And if I can't do nothing in Jerusalem, ain't really me trying to go to Samaria and the other parts of the world. And so that's just my thinking. And so, Lord, I said, you're just so good. She was just having a fit. Oh, I just love apples and grapes. Oh, she goes, oh, Lord. So I decided, I don't know about what you decided, but I decided to hit my neighborhood first. It's 22 houses there, and I'm going to every house. And I started knocking on the door, telling them about Jesus. If you don't know Jesus, he is. Amen. Now, that's my personal way I feel. But I just want to thank the Lord for you all and thank the Lord for being here today. Will you stand? We're going to pray, and I'm not going to keep you too long. People should stop saying that. I'm going to keep you as long as the Holy Ghost keep you here. And if he keep us here all day to next week, we'll be here. Shoot. I'm not rushing anywhere from God. I don't rush any place else I go. I don't. I don't rush nowhere I go. And I go, I'll go and stay as long as I want to stay. And you do too. Amen. So I just want to thank the Lord for all of you. Father, we thank you. We give you praise today. You are our Father. You are. You've been so good. I heard how you touch the brother's back. So it's hope for me. Praise. I was going to tell him afterward, but God is a healer. He heals us when we call and he touches us. You know, he's not going to let you suffer above what you're able. He's a good God. I can say that because he's been a good God to me and to my household. And so I just want to thank him for doing that. And thank him for the people who think to pray. When you know somebody asks you to pray, stop and pray. Don't just call a name. No, lift them up to God and pray. Because you can't never tell just what that's doing because God hears and answers prayer. So I just want to thank you today, Lord. Bless this word today, Father, that you gave me for your people. I ask it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Hallelujah. I want to go to Matthew 6. God gave me this. God has begun to deal with me differently since I've gotten older. I got messages other ways when I was younger and still got some of the books there. I had always wrote messages down in like in a composition book. And I got them stacked up. So I'm going to go back through them. Yeah, I am, because I need to know them messages, I've been preaching a long time. I was looking at when I was ordained. I said, wow. You forget. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're going to start in Matthew 6. Father, I want to thank you again. You just been good. I just really appreciate you, Lord, letting me live. And, Lord, I know my latter days are going to be greater. So there's going to be a change. When God said new wine, there will be new wine because he said it. And so, Lord, I know what that means. So I'm looking forward to it, Lord. And may your people look forward to having a new experience in the Holy Ghost. A new outpouring of your spirit in the land and in this church and in every place people are praying and looking for you, Lord. I ask it in Jesus' name. Because you got to be wanting it, I don't just flop on people that, you ain't got time for that now. I don't think. God, he loves. His love is just amazing. And I want to thank God for those out there listening, because I do get occasionally get somebody say they heard. And so I just really appreciate the Lord opening up to and blessing my brother like that. And he gave that to God as a gift. He's unpaid. He does it because he loves God. Wouldn't take a damn, would you? Maybe 100 dams, maybe. He's just so sweet. I just love him. You know, he just who he is. One thing the Lord has taught me, don't try to change people. Take them just the way they are. When you know a person, that's that person, and you ask God to show you how to treat that person. Don't try to treat them like you treat Gwen, like you treat Sister Vicky. You love everybody now, you know what I'm saying? But there are people and they're different. I've learned that. There are people are different. They just are. You know what I'm saying? So just, you may say something to me and then she say something to me. If you're the kind of person that maybe say, you know, people get all upset in the church about some girl, she really, ooh, Lord, have girl, I've been through a lot. I've been through church breakups and break-ins. And I've been here a long time. Someone, and I look back over my life and I examine things. I say, Lord, I want this to be good. I want it to be good. Even in my transition to heaven, I want it to be good. Churches break up over that. They do. And by the way, I'm not going nowhere right now. That one told me. I'll be here in probably in my early 90s. But however, think about how much you love God. Think about it, you know, but I'm not 25 anymore. I'm not 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. I'm 80. And I can't live forever. And I sure don't want to live forever down here. No, Lord, have mercy. Whoo, Lord. Amen. So I don't know why. This just comes. I didn't plan this. I really didn't plan this. But may God bless, you know, the transition of this church. Yes. Anybody looking at me? No, I don't know. I'm not going nowhere. I'm just bless the church. I've seen churches split up. I've been in a lot of churches. I've seen them split up. I've seen them, you know, act crazy. I've seen people break friendships and just a whole lot of mess, you know. It'd be so like take them about almost a year to get back in order. Amen. So you know there has to be a transition. I can't stay here forever and don't want to. Mm-hmm. This is not the place I want to be forever. Amen. So let us pray that everything will stay lovely, that we'll love one another, truly love one another, that we'll truly love each other, you know, and don't go through things where it take a month to get things straightened out. Anybody hear me? Okay. Amen. And by the way, I'm not going nowhere right now, so don't be trying to write that down. I'll be here for a while, honey. Amen. I want to go to, Matthew 6. And the Lord gave me most of my message now. He gave me, I'm going to be waking up and he'll whisper something to me. I said, oh, okay. That's where I'll go. So he whispered the Lord's Prayer to me, which, I don't know, he said it was in this way, pray. But most times now, I start with this prayer. You know, people got something against that, but I don't worry about people. I'm too old to worry about folks, what they think. But I start with this prayer. So I want to start with Matthew 6. And Jesus talked about the alms, the alm giving. You know, when you give, you're supposed to give without sounding off. I gave sister so-and-so this, I gave brother so-and-so that. Don't let your right hand, he said, know what your left hand doing. You know what I'm saying? So you're not supposed to, you know, I gave so-and-so $50 less. Come on now. This is not what Jesus told us to do. And so he said that alms may be in secret, that your Father, which is in secret, shall reward you openly. Amen. So when you pray, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues, in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily, I say unto you, they have their reward. The Lord just touched my heart. Where's Donna? Where's your wife? okay. I love her. I see her. And I see you guys, you know. I see you too. I don't want her to think I was overlooking her, you know. Sister, I love you all. Okay. When thou prayest, thou shalt not be as a hypocrite, for they love to pray, standing in the synagogues in the corner of the streets, that they may be seen to be in. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But when you pray, or when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thy father which is in secret, and thy father which is in secret, shall reward thee openly. And I don't know why the Lord just put this on my heart. I get up in the morning. That's what usually he's been dealing with me now. I'll get up in the morning, and he'll whisper a scripture. He'll start telling me something. And he kept telling me, I said, Lord, okay, so here we go. But when you pray, use not vain repetition as the heathens, for they think they shall be done for their much speaking. Be ye like unto them. Did I skip it? He says, so I'm 9. After this manner, therefore, pray ye. And I noticed the first word. And I prayed this prayer many times. I just pray sometimes when I get down on my knees before every morning when I rise, I pray this prayer. I pray like this. You know what I'm saying? I started off like this. I enter into his courts saying this. I noticed, but I had never noticed that when you first start, he say, our Father. He's talking to the disciples at the time because they had said, Lord, teach us how to pray. Not my Father, not necessarily that you, in your, when you're praying, you say, you know, you don't mind. But he started off to let me know that he wants a body in this earth. Our Father. That's cooperative. Now, I've prayed this prayer all 50, 60 years. But he let me know that the love, I'm trying to explain, that the love that we have for one another is amazing to God. He loves it. He wants us to love. He don't want you to come to church, you know, because this church don't do that, though. He don't want you to come to church with something there in your heart or whatever against your brother or your sister. You don't like the this or the other. Da, 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 da. Straighten all that stuff out. It can't be straightened out before you get here. Straighten all your heart out before you get here. So he says, our Father. He didn't tell him to say my Father. And I thought, wow, I had never seen. Much as I prayed this prayer, he say, our Father. That means I collected a body. Our, all the Christians, our Father, all the saints, our Father. And here's the location, which is in heaven. I thought, Lord. So he said, because there's a father, people got in hell. He told the disciples, he said, your father is from hell. That's your father, but my father is in heaven. So we want to know the location that we praying our Father collectively, which art in heaven. Glory, glory, glory. Oh, I read this so many times, but that just really got me. He said, hallowed be thy name. So I had to look up to make sure he's telling us what to say. Hallowed be thy name. What that mean? He said, let your name be worshipped. Let your name be exalted. Let your name be adored on earth. I want to hear something else I want you to see. On and in. That's why I love the King Version, because the King James Version. Because I understand it better, okay? But he said, thy will be done. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Okay, let's go hallowed. Don't go too fast. Help me. Your name be worshipped. Your name be exalted. Your name be honored and adored on earth. In heaven, ask God to move. Get into the world, the people will worship and treasure his name. And many times I ask the Lord, let your name and your word cover the earth, cover this earth like the waters cover the seas. Let your name go all over the earth, Lord, just like the seas go all over. And I can see the waters in my mind. I say, Lord, just like the waters run and the big oceans, let your name run across this world that man may know who you are. I want people to know God and Your place in my Jerusalem is in my neighborhood, by the way. I got 22 houses in there. That's my Jerusalem. I start right there in my Jerusalem. And I just about know just about everybody in there. Come to find out, it's a couple that live in the thing that go to Brother McCarty's church, who I went to Brother McCarty's church. Yeah, I know Brother McCarty well. So I haven't got up early enough. I don't know how, you know, because this lady that I changed stuff with, she don't get up till 1 o'clock. So older people, not me, I'm up. I'm up at 3. I wish I could sleep to 1 o'clock. But most older people get up later. Is that right? I mean, if you don't have a farm like y'all got, probably a big place to take care of, they get up. Well, y'all talk to me. Do they sleep all day or are they up? Really? Some of them get up. Yeah, I get up. I wake up at 3. I wake up at 3 and I get up at 5. Huh? It depends, huh? It depends what you do, yeah. Yeah. Kids asleep, they sleep? Ooh, okay. He says, so hallowed. We want to know what hallowed mean now. What did I say hallowed mean? Holy, sanctified, worthy, hallelujah. Worthy, hallelujah. Adored, hallelujah. That people would treasure you, Lord, above everything else. Let your name be known in the earth. Because I believe at the name of Jesus, what does it say? Every knee should bow. It's something about the name of Jesus. Honest to goodness. It's something about his name, honestly. You can talk to a heathen and mention his name. I don't care if they play it like they don't. But something about the name of Jesus. It's something about his name that changes things. Amen. Brother, didn't you tell me that, you know, when your back was hurting? What'd you say?
I cried out, Jesus, help me.
Jesus. Because it's something about his name. Because my back gives me problems, too. And the boy, he hears it. Jesus. Sometimes I don't say nothing but his name. And it's something about his name. It will heal you. It will give you joy. It will give you peace. It's something about his name. So when we say our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And that is the truth. His name, there's no other name you can mention. You can say Dr. Florsham. I went to Dr. Sodom, you know, whatever the name is. But there's nothing like when you call his name. It's miraculous. Honestly, his name is miraculous. You call his name, you could be, I mean, just really in a bad, wherever y'all get, and just say Jesus, and things change. I don't know about you, but it's true for me. You can be, you know, you can be feeling bad about something. You know what I'm saying? Like I feel about what happened yesterday. Well, I really feel bad to tell you. I feel bad. But it's something about the name of Jesus. And I said, Lord, let your name be glorified in me, because I don't want to have nothing against nobody. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to, you know, well, you know, I don't want to do that. So Jesus, please help me. Forgive me. Because your name is, I know that everybody is different. You taught me that many years ago. You're not the same. Sister, I'm not like you, Vicky. I'm not like you. I'm me. And you don't be trying to be like nobody else. I raised my granddaughter. I said, listen, you get up there and you be you. Don't try to be me. Don't try to be Sister so-and-so. Don't try to be Sister Harvey. Be you. And look what it did. Because God got something in you. You know, you may look at other people and say, well, I wish. No. Be you. Be all of you you can be. Be the best you can be. You just as great as anybody else. Amen. You ain't nobody else like you. Amen. That's how God is so good. I bet you, now they tell me that we all have even different fingerprints. Now, that's what I heard. How can millions of people have a different fingerprint? You talking about an amazing God. An amazing God. So I can make it. I can make it, Al. When I think about the goodness of God, I can make it. I can go through my trials and with a smile. And I mean, I don't have to pretend anymore. In my heart of hearts, I can do it because God put it there. But without him, I tell him, I said, Lord, without you, I can't do this. I'm just telling you now, I'm tired. But you give me strength. You will give me the courage. And you will make, listen, I'm talking, he will change your heart. I bet the thing that Jackie didn't want to do, and you didn't, but you called God, hallelujah, you didn't want to do, but you called him, so you didn't know. But your attitude, come on now, your attitude changes. Somebody hear me here. Somebody hear me here. Because there are things in life that you got to do you don't want to do. Hallelujah. There are people that you have to deal with that you don't want to deal with. You telling me nothing, shoot. Been here a long time. But something about the name of Jesus. It's something about his name. Something about his name that would change your attitude. It's a miracle. And I said, Lord, you know, you're just something else. I tell me, I said, you are just something else. Ooh, wee, I'm just, you something, Lord. I know what I feel. I know I'm human. I know what I'm feeling, but I know, hallelujah. And when he gave me this, I said, Lord, you changed me. I hallow your name, Lord. Yes. I hallow it. Your name is above all names. And at your name, every knee should bow. Every tongue confess. At your name. Oh, it's wonderful. Oh, what a name. Oh, what a name, what a name, what a name. Yes, Lord. Now, what else he say? Hallowed be thy name. That one got me more, I think, than anything did. Thy kingdom come. Is that next? Come, Lord. Come, Lord. Thy will be done. Now I'm supposed to throw somebody off here. Here it is. He said, thy will be done. And everybody said, on earth. Uh-uh. He didn't say that. They ain't in there. In my Bible, name. I'm glad it ain't. Because that is not the. He said, thy will be done. In earth. In you. In me. He want his will to be done in us. And which makes perfect sense. Because if his will ain't done in you, how is it going to get done on earth? If it ain't in you, how is it going to get on the earth? So your will be done in me. In earth. You are the earth he talking about there. Your will be done in earth. In earth. You the earth. You can see me after church and it still will be the same with me. I want his will done in me. He wants his will done in you. He can't have his will done in the earth until we get it in the earth here. We are the first earth, his earth, and y'all was saying that in your Sunday school class. We are made of earth, and we are the earth, and he wants his will to be done in us first. Then it could be done on earth. And he wants his will done in us. If his will is done in heaven. Wow, that's a big thing. Yeah. Wow. That alone. As it is in heaven. Now, I don't know how we pray, but seems like we're supposed to get something every day where I read this. Did you ever read that? Give us this day our daily bread. God want to feed us every day. God want to hear from us and fix us up and give us love and whatever we, Give us our daily bread. Daily. Oh, Jesus. He'd be there every day to give you what you need to make the day. To go to this job where this dude is getting on your nerve. Where this lady getting on your nerve. Where people get on your nerve or whoever. I talk to people. They just, you know, they're the sweetest people. And if I talk long enough, they'll tell me their heart. I don't know. People just talk to me. They'll tell me everything. You know, I meet folks. Listen, I can be in the line. And I tell them, I say, hi, honey. I turn around, hi, honey. For I'm out the Lord, I know her mama's name, her daddy's name, when she graduated. And that's just that's my personality. I love people, and people respond. Because when I'm saying hi, honey, I really mean that. I really mean this little lady behind me. And she's sometimes, one lady, I was at the good one of them, up over, where's that over there? That store over there where you get stuff for a dollar, you know, sometimes you have a lot. Yeah, Dollar Tree, not that one, but it's the lady that we go to see. Up in O'Fallon. Grace, I was over Grace's. And I was outside in a Grace, over to Grace's. And I was outside and this lady came up to me. And I don't know how we got it, but then I just fell in love with her. Hi, honey. I said, how are you doing? Are you okay? Because she was really teary. And I said, honey, what's the matter? And I don't know what else I said to her. I don't write it down. So by the time we got in the store, she done fell in love with me. So we gets up to the counter, and she done paid for everything that I bought. You know. Then she goes back out. She said, she went back out for the glory of God. Came back in. Wait a minute. Celeste, here. Now, she done bought all my stuff now. And I get stuff, believe me. Okay. She said, open your hand. $100. I said, now, Lord, I'm a very blessed woman. I don't need this woman's $100. What in the world? He said, I did it for her. And I said, honey, thank you. That's so sweet. And listen, if anybody, people love Jesus. They loved him. Children love. So you can't fool kids. So you make, you can't fool. When kids came around, they was all around Jesus sitting on his lap. They felt that the love that he wanted to offer to the world. They felt it. They'd be up on him and hugging his neck and they'd be, get on down. He said, no. Suffer the little children to come unto me. Uh-oh, you forgot this though. He said, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. You ain't read that part. That's where we are. We ought to be all up on him, hugging his neck and sitting in his lap. And Jesus, yeah, you know yesterday, so I said, honey, we ought to get a relationship with Jesus where we can just be like a kid. You know, just put your arm around his neck and say, Lord, you know what I'm feeling. You know, I do. I said, Lord, you know what I'm feeling. You know where I am. But you help me to come out of this like you want me to. Give me a grade like you want me to have. You know, do something for me. And if it's somebody else, I'll pray for you too. But I've asked the Lord to help me. Help me, sister, to be a Christian. I don't want to just say I'm a Christian. I don't want to say, well, I'm a Christian. I took you against this. Putting tags on your car, tags on, you don't need no tag. All you need to just be who you are and it will show up. Give God a good clap. Give him a good. Oh, he's so good. Thank you, Lord. Thy will be done, Lord. Thy will be done in earth. Hallelujah. You. He wants his will done in you as it is in heaven. Now, you know, the heavens, all the angels, I've read in Revelations, all these different things I don't understand, but they obey God. They stand at attention when they see him. They obey him, and that's what he wants from us in this generation, every generation, but especially this last. He wants us to obey him. Obey him. And don't think when he tell you something, he didn't mean it, because he do. Some people think, you know what I'm saying? Pray. And make your location, it is your Jerusalem, that's where you live. Hello? If that's not your Jerusalem, then what he's saying, go to Jerusalem first. What he's talking about? Somebody with their hands want to tell me? Where is your Jerusalem? Well, you round your neighborhood down the street. That lady that's sick down there has been down there that you didn't go to see. That's your Jerusalem. And I believe God makes us whatever we want to use. Hallelujah. And so he said, what does it say? And we'll be done with it. Give us this day. Now ain't that some? Our daily bread. Not Hostess, a bunny bread, but that which feeds our soul. It's promised to us every day. So I'm looking at the Lord, and all of a sudden I see myself, said, give me this day my daily bread. Give us this day our daily bread. So it's something that God wants to give you, give us every single day. So, sister, if he's giving this sister every single day, and it's 365 days in a year, by that many days, we ought to be full, full, full. Or either 10 days, we ought to be full, full, full. So we should be full enough to always be able to talk to your neighbor or that person that don't get on your nerves. How y'all know? Because I talk to many people, and I talk to my kids, and I talk to everybody, because my kids are perfect, you know, but I talk to to people, and they got jobs. They ain't got nothing good to say. I don't hear too many people who got a job out here got anything good to say. Honestly, this is pitiful. How about your job? Okay, good. Give us. He said, "Listen to this, and forgive us our debts." You know, I pray, God, that all God's people would get out of debt. Get out of debt. It'd be nice. I'll let it alone. Okay. As we forgive people who owe us money. Anybody got somebody owe them something? Maybe somebody on the line got somebody owe them something. Lead us not into temptation. And I've always questioned God about that. Yeah, I have. Have you ever thought about that? And leaders, I said, Lord, now, what do that mean? By the way, he ain't told me yet. I said, Lord, you would lead us into temptation? And lead us not into temptation. Al, you got to study that. Lead us not into temptation. I said, Lord, you would never lead me into temptation. Okay. I got to go back and study that. But deliver us from what? So I believe temptation could be evil, couldn't you? For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Now here's something strange about me. When I pray this prayer, even though I know it, I never say amen. Because I ain't through. Amen means so be it. That's just me. That's just me. I shouldn't have told nobody that, but that's me. I don't say amen. Now you say amen. I'm saying nothing wrong with it. I'm just saying amen be so be it, and that's the end of that. Nope. I'm going to be praying some more today, Lord. I'm going to be back. That's where I look at it. I'll be back again all day long. And so maybe at the end of the day, I'll say so be it. But not now. I always want to be able to come to you as my Father, always, and believe that you hear me. Let me see y'all to believe. Some people say, I don't know if God hear me when I pray. I don't have nobody like that in here, right? Everybody here know God hears you when you pray? Hello? Do God hear you? He hear you? So if you know he hear you, if we know he hear us, why was you crying the other night because he ain't answered? Or you think he ain't going to answer? If he hear you, hello? If you know that he hears you, you ask him. And I know most Christians know when God has heard. You know when God has heard you. And when he's heard you, won't you let that alone and give him time to do it? Because it may not be the time, see. Things you asking may not be the time. You know, we got to realize that God is God. He's not like us. He don't think the way. He don't reason the way we. He don't reason near the way we reason. Well, why ain't this happened, Lord? I asked you last year, why have not that happened? It ain't time. And it don't need to happen because it may change you something in you or something else may happen. But he's going to answer you. I say he's going to answer you. And once you know he's going to answer you, let it alone. Pray something, get something else to pray about. I mean, don't just, do that to him. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory. How long? Ain't that wonderful? Ain't nobody changing up there. Y'all ain't going to change another guard. So, no. He, our Father, that I have known all these 80-some years. He is the man I know I have prayed to. He brought me out of things. Somebody told me to write a book. I said, oh, well. You ought to write a book. I don't know. I might. But I could. I'm not from here. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, in the slums. And I could write a book. I could write a book how God kept me. You didn't come from Michigan, but you could write a book too how God kept you. Gwen just got to sit up there talk about how God keep her. How, he loves you just like he loved her. He may not have to give you no hats or something, but God loves you. You can remember the times when something supernatural happened to you and you wonder, what in the world? Praise the Lord. Well, something where you know you couldn't put your friend, you couldn't write it down what happened. Because it happened because God loves you. He brought you through some things, hallelujah, that you know only God could have brought you through. Only God. Praise the Lord. You remember that time you almost got hit? Especially if you're on this crazy highway out there. Praise the Lord. These people drive like they're going crazy. Amen. But you remember the time, you could take any part of your life and know, I could have fell. I could have did this. I could have got hit. I could have got shot. I could have did this. But God, it was God that kept us. He kept us for a purpose, and he wants us to fulfill it. He's asking us to fulfill that purpose now. He wants us to fulfill his purpose. He's a good God. I just, all I can stand here and tell y'all is that, and I'm just saying this with you all in your hearts, he is a good God. Yes, he is. I say, Father, you're just so good. Amen. Amen. Well, and you know, whatever you go through, you can take it to him, sister. Some people you can't tell you everything, but you can sure take it to him because you ain't going to hear, Susie mention it down the road, personal things or whatever. God is a good God. God is a good God. Brother Joe, come here. God gave me a gift. Oh, I've been here this gift. How long, yeah? God gave me the gift of healing in his hand. Why this hand? I don't. You know why this hand? I had a lady minister, and she needed some money. And I don't know how, but I gave it with this hand or something. But God anointed this hand. And I asked him one time, why you anointing my left hand? Why not my right hand? So I stopped being so stupid. I said, Lord, anoint my right foot, but whatever you want to anoint. And I put it on whatever you say. I'm going to put my hand that God has anointed. Is that right, Tawana? They've been knowing me since. Yes.
a good marriage is people staying. You know, 66 years ago. It is me. It is. And he's still my honey. He really is. I tell him. I'm going to ask God to give you scripture to read. You are an excellent teacher. What you've been doing in the class has come back. And I'm telling you, very much love. You are loved, Joel, for the words that you speak to the saints, and you are loved for that class. I don't know, Joel, you like I know Vicky. My daughter just adores you. And she said, Mama, she is the best teacher. Thank you for coming and obeying the Lord in this little beauty church. Watch it grow.
Yes, Lord.
Watch it grow.
Yes.
Watch what God is going to do here. God is going to be God in this place. I've always asked him that, to be God. And to me, he can do anything. He can turn that tree upside down, move that building, whatever he wants to do, he can do it. I believe that, sir. I believe in God. I ask God to give you strength in your body, sister. Praise the Lord. Whatever you need in your body, that's out of place or whatever, that the Lord will heal it. Because you never spoke to me anything about anything like that. So, you know, so just whatever you need in your body that needs to be healed, I ask, Lord, that you do this. To confirm your word in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord and bless her. Praise the Lord. Give her strength, God, to stand. Praise the Lord. Nobody knows what she say to you at night or whisper how she feels. But you know everything. So I'm asking the Lord to touch my sister Vicky in the name of Jesus and for the glory of God. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God has been very good to you all the year. You're a person you don't brag. You know, I got this, I got that. I appreciate that. And I look around. We had a lady here that did a lot of stuff. I said, they don't know for me. You don't know what's for nothing. I ain't never again. Thank you. Thank you for obeying the Lord. Thank you.
Yes.
I appreciate it. God bless you.
Yes, thank
you. Yeah. He had a time with me to tell you, too, because I preached against women ministers. On the radio. Yeah, I preached against women getting a ministry, girl, because my church taught that. I preached against it. And I had a radio broadcast, and I didn't call myself preaching. I was teaching, I guess, you know. But I preached it. It took a lot of time for God to put me here. But I finally decided to obey him. I'm thankful that I did. And if you love God, you're going to be in one day, so you might come off when you get too old. You know, so you can give him the best parts of your life. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'm waiting for somebody. You know what? I told God something. I gave God something. I said, Lord, now when that happened, I know. So there's going to be a change in this church. A good change. A godly change. And it's going to be what he said. People have seen people in this church and seen God bless people. We're not doing this for nobody. Shoot, we're doing this for Jesus. We want to see people heal. I want to see God be God. I told him, I said, Lord, you're God. Be God. Because I don't believe it's nothing that he cannot do. There's no sickness he cannot heal. I don't believe it. I believe he heals sickness. I believe he raised the dead. I believe he is God. And nobody is like him. Because can't nobody make a tree. Can't nobody make a grass grow. Can't nobody put the sun up there. Can't nobody put the sky up there. Can't nobody make the clouds. I believe he's God. And there's nobody like him. And I'm expecting it to happen in this place and in every church that will receive it. Because he wants to be God. He wants people to come in here and get what they need. You know, you don't want people come here and then go out like they came. In Jesus' name. I'm through.
Lord, I've delivered my soul. God is, I can't explain it who he is. I just can't explain. He's just God. I watch how he changed me. There's some things I didn't want to do. Places I didn't want to go. But I noticed how what he changed. I said, Lord, have mercy. Because, you know, you can say, well, I want to do this, but really in your mind back there, you know, hey, kid, you're still fussing and don't want to do it. But when God do something, it's done. It's done in your mind. It's done in your body. It's done. It's just like it was never there before. It's done. Will you stand? Lord, I love you. And I have delivered my soul. Hallelujah. I pray for my brothers and sisters as we go into the next part of our service. The only way we know how is another way you show it to us. And I pray for those, Lord, out there that's listening, that's been streamed, that the Lord would touch you and bless you. And bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, and bring you out. And you that's in the valley of decision, that you would make a decision today to serve this only true and living God. You would make a decision. Because this is where you're missing it at. James can't help you. Judy can't help you. Margaret can't help you. It's God you're looking for. And he'll get you out and help you through this trial you're going through. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Anybody here need prayer? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want to thank God for my son that's in my class, and we've been having a time with, we thought it was going to be easy, but we've been, I said, I'm going to have to go back home and study this some more, sugar. We're supposed to be doing, what are we doing? Well, genealogies. And I said, and so Coach said, you know, Pastor, I think this guy had that one. I said, goodness gracious. So then he go online. He said, now the line says so-and-so, so-and-so, so-and-so. I said, oh, Lord. I said, I'll tell you what, Kofi, I'm going back and get this Bible, and I'll put this thing in order. And we're going to be sitting out here messing with this board for next year. That ain't going to happen. Praise the Lord. God is good. Prepare yourself. But you know what? You know, we say this, but you should always be prepared. Because have you ever thought about what he said about coming in a twinkling of an eye? Therefore, brethren, how much should we not stay prepared? You know what I'm saying? He ain't going to wait until, because you know somebody say, forgive me, he'll do it. No. In a twinkle of an eye, that's like that. Wow. Say wow.
Wow.
Praise the Lord. Amen. So God, we pray as we go into the next part of the service that you will really give us the understanding of your blood and body. Yes, Lord. Give us understanding, Lord. All who want to come this way, this is the way we do it. I'm looking for another way, maybe to give it to as we walk in the door. I don't know. I've been to churches that do that. Would you come to the front, the one who want to